First, there was Slugs versus Coffee Grounds. Then Slugs versus Diatomaceous Earth. And now, Slugs versus Eggshells. In my previous experiments, I found that both Coffee Grounds and Diatomaceous Earth help deter slugs, at least when first applied to the soil. Today, I thought I'd put ground eggshells to the test. As before, I conducted the experiment in a plastic bin under lights in my grow room. I filled the bottom of the bin with soil, covered half the soil with ground eggshells, and placed a piece of cardboard in the center. The cardboard served as a neutral starting position for the slugs. I then ran four consecutive 10-minute tests to see how many times the slugs traveled over soil versus eggshells. If a slug moved briefly over eggshells but turned back to the cardboard or soil, I did not count it as a trip over eggshells. I started test one with 8 slugs, 2 medium-sized and 6 small. Before I even finished placing the slugs on the cardboard, one of the small ones took off into the soil. Next, another one ventured into the eggshells. The 2 larger slugs considered moving into the eggshells, but had second thoughts and turned back. Then 3 more headed for the soil. Finally, the last one of the small slugs and one of the larger ones that turned back from the eggshells sought refuge underneath the cardboard in the soil. So after test 1, we have 7 trips over soil and 1 over eggshells. I was only able to locate 5 out of the 8 slugs after test 1. I put the slugs that had traveled on the soil on the lower portion of the cardboard and the one that traveled over eggshells on the upper portion. I wanted to keep an eye on him to see if his experience in the eggshells would keep him from moving in this test. One of the small slugs led the way into the soil. Here you can see one of the slugs I couldn't locate from the last test. Next, one of the larger slugs moved into the soil, followed by another small one. Finally, the last 2 slugs moved into the soil. So all 5 slugs traveled through the soil, bringing our total count to 12 over soil and 1 over eggshells. For test 3, I was able to recover only 6 of the slugs. After placing the slugs on the cardboard, one of the little guys led the troops into the soil. One of his larger comrades appeared to follow, but then briefly crossed the eggshells before going AWOL up the side of the bin. Here, a large slug ventured into the soil with a little buddy riding piggyback. The little guy eventually fell off. Finally, one more slug traveled into the soil, and one remained on the cardboard. I won't count the AWOL slug or the one that hitched a ride, and of course the one that stayed on the cardboard won't count. So for test 3, 3 of the slugs traveled over the soil, and none over the eggshells. That brings us to 15 trips over soil, and just 1 over eggshells. It looks like we have a pattern here. I was able to recover only 4 slugs for test 4. They were getting better and better at hiding in the soil. After placing the slugs on the cardboard, one of the big boys led the way into the soil. Next, a small one moved into the soil. Then one of the larger ones headed over the eggshells, but just for long enough to escape up the side of the bin. Finally, one of the little guys ventured into the soil. We won't count the one slug that tried to escape. Excluding him, there were 3 trips over the soil and none over eggshells, bringing our total to 18 trips over soil and 1 over eggshells. So it looks like ground eggshells are a pretty good slug deterrent. We already sprinkle them on our soil for the calcium and the grit they provide our earthworms and red wigglers. So it's great to know they also deter those pesky slugs. Well, that's all for now. Thank you very much for watching. And until next time, remember, you can change the world 1 yard at a time.